In a previous video, we created a database, and now in this video, I want to show you how to start adding tables to that database. Now, our database was a fictitious company that we're starting, and so the first table we're going to put into it is an employee table. Now, before you start creating the tables, we need to address what columns are going to go into the table, and more importantly, what is the data type for each of these columns. One of the benefits of a database, storing information in a database over a spreadsheet, is in a database management system, when we create tables, we can define exactly the type of data that goes into each column. And if somebody puts some data in a column that shouldn't belong there, the system will raise an error at that point. We can control what kind of data goes into each column through something called data types. So when we get to creating tables, when we say I want to add a column called employee ID, we then have to immediately say what kind of data is going to go in that column. And then we'll say I want a column called first name, and we have to immediately say what kind of data is going to go into that column. So let's take a few minutes to talk about data types. The MySQL website has a great documentation, and on chapter 11 of that documentation page, and I'll include a link in this video, they have an entire chapter devoted just to data types. All right, now the three types that we're going to use most frequently in this class are the numeric, right? I'm going to store some kind of number in that column. There are date and time types, and there are string types. Okay, string being text. I want to store text. So for instance, first name, last name, we're going to use some kind of string type. Now within these types, for instance numeric, there are all sorts of other subclasses, if you will. So for integer values, there is something called an int, a small int, a tiny int, a medium int, and a big int. Well, what's the difference? It has to do with how large of a number can be stored in these data types and how much memory they're using up. So to give you an example, let's go back to the chapter heading. Right down here under 11.8, they talk about storage requirements. So for instance, I'll scroll down. A tiny int is only 1 byte. But the downside to that is it can only hold a number from -128 to 128. So if I wanted to store the number 1,000, well, I can't use a tiny int data type. So when choosing your data types, you need to research a little bit. What's the largest possible number that I think I'm going to put into this column, and then find a data type that will hold that number. So then you may ask, well, why don't I just make everything a big int, right? No matter what I put in, it's going to hold, my number will fit. Well, the problem is it's 8 bytes for every row you put in, and where you have a column that's a big int, you're going to take 8 bytes. So, in a really small database, it probably doesn't matter, but if you start storing a million records and you use this 8-byte data type when all you're putting in are small integers in there, the size of your database becomes huge and it's unnecessary. In this same documentation, I'll go back up, you want to know, well, how big of a number can I put in? So they have, right here, a table that shows you. So for a tiny int, I can go -128 to 127, or, and I'll show you in a minute, there's this unsigned keyword that says, oh, I'll never put negative values in here. So then you can go from 0 to 255. So for a small integer, if I'm going to put in negative numbers, well, then this is my range. If I'm not going to put in negative numbers, then this is my range. And so you get the idea, and it also right here shows how many bytes it's going to take to store that value. So what if I'm going to store a number that's not an integer type? So we'll go back to numeric types, and they have fixed and floating point. So fixed types are when you need an exact value, and very often that's we're dealing with money. So they have a decimal or numeric data type right here. So let's just say we're going to use decimal. It has two parameters it wants in addition to the fact that it's decimal, and that is how large, how many digits. They call this the precision, and how many of those digits will be to the right of the decimal point. That is called the scale. And here's where people get goofed up. The 5 in this case, includes everything, meaning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 digits here. 2 of them are to the right of the decimal point. A lot of people will read this as being, I have 5 to the left of the decimal and 2 after it. No, 5 total, 2 after it. So for instance, if I wanted to store a GPA for a school grade, right? So maybe you have a GPA of 3.14. What kind of scale and precision would I need to put on that? Well, realistically, that's 3 digits. 3 and then comma 2, because I had 2 after the decimal point. In different database management systems, they will always have these same numeric data types, but sometimes they have a different syntax. So I believe SQL Server has something called money rather than decimal. And so you have to, for each system, you need to kind of look up your data types and see what words they use and the value ranges for those. So if we're going to use money, we'll use the decimal. Let's go back to numeric. Remember, there's floating points. So for instance, pi is 3.14 and it goes on forever. Basically the same thing. We could use the word float. And again, you have this scale and precision idea, so I won't go any more into that right now, but same idea. So let's go back to data types again. The other ones are date and time. For the most part, they're pretty self-explanatory. There's this year type, which is kind of interesting. It'll hold either a 2 or 4-digit year right there. If you're gonna hold the date, you're gonna wanna use a date data type. Notice how it displays it year and then month and then day. It's easier to recognize on this one. Year, month, day. Well, they show it right here. So that's how it'll display it. And there are ways that we can change how it displays, but that's how it's going to store it, I should say. And now let's move on to string data types. So for that, for the most part, we're going to stick with char and varchar. And so what's the difference between char and varchar? This stands for variable length, and char character stands for fixed length. So for instance, I want to store the two-digit state code in a column, right? It's always 2 digits, no matter what the state. It's 2-digit code. So in that case, I would use a char data type. And you put the number of characters it's going to hold. So in this case, it'd be char 2. If it's going to be variable length, like first name, last name, I have no idea how long people's names are going to be. So in that case, I will use varchar. And the same thing with varchar, you put a number after it representing the max size that it's going to be. So now, what's the difference between char 4 and varchar? Well, char 4, if I just put one character inside a column, it's still going to take up the amount of space as if I were putting in 4. Where if on varchar I put in one character, well then it will shrink the size of that memory location down to just hold that one character. And then in this table they kind of give an example of that, right? If I'm only holding an empty string, it's going to take up 4 bytes no matter what, whereas a varchar will just take up 1. Or if I put in an AB, this guy's going to take up 4 bytes, this guy will take up 3. And anyway, you get the idea. And by the way, I believe the max value for a varchar is 255. Now, I'm going to put a link to a couple websites that talk about the importance of getting the size of your data type right, because students tend to blow this off, right? So they'll go first name, we'll create a varchar, and they'll just make it 255, right? And so 255 characters is a lot of space for a first name, right? It's probably not realistic. So another example would be employee ID. They may make employee ID like a big int, which holds a number up to a trillion or something, and obviously you're never going to have that many employees, and so you're taking up all of this space holding numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's important that you choose a data type that matches the size. This webpage I just pulled up is a great explanation of, well, why not make it varchar 200? Because the whole idea of varchar is it's going to shrink based on if I only put in 20 characters. Well, as you read through this website, he'll go on to mention it actually does create a performance hit when you start to do queries and stuff because it's looking like you're planning on 200 characters. And so when the query optimizer runs, it starts assuming that when in actuality you're only putting in 20 characters at a time. So again, take a minute to read this site. I'll put the link, but it talks about, make sure you put a value here that truly represents the largest amount of characters you're going to put in there. And I'll put in this link also, but I thought this article was quite good. And number one, size matters. Always use the smallest data size will accommodate the largest possible value. And then it goes on to some other things also about what makes a good primary key. Don't use float, real, date, time for primary keys because they're just, you're going to end up with a performance issue when you do that. Again, I'll put the link in. So if you have a minute, take read these articles also. So having covered all that about data types, taking a look at our employee table, what would be the data type we do for each of, should we use for each of these columns? So employee ID, it's obviously, this is going to be a primary key. It's just a number we're going to assign to each employee. It has to be unique, and it's going to be some integer data type. So if we run over to our manual in the MySQL website, these are the integer data types. Depending on the size of your company, you may want to go tiny int, or if you think you might grow, you maybe want to go small int in that case. So right over here, we can just put the word small int. Well, first name and last name are going to be varchar. All right, but then the question is, well, what's the largest it may happen to be? So maybe 75, you could maybe go 50, right there. Enter, and then same thing here. Maybe the last name could be a little bit larger. And so here, how about on the email? That again is going to be variable length because it's based on people's names. So let's just go 100 on that. Now, what would you use for salary? Well, again, money needs to be precise as we do math in that, so it's going to be decimal. So for this decimal data type, remember there's two other additional numbers we need to put under it, and one's that's called the precision and the scale. So the precision is the total size of the number, how many digits are going to be in it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and let's say you're going to have the 0.00, so that's 6, 7. And just in case, what if you have a really rich person like a CEO or something? So I'm going to go ahead and make that 8. And then two of those digits will be beyond on the right side of the decimal for that. For a higher date, we'll just use a date data type. Now, phone and Social Security are interesting. They look like numbers to you and I, right? We view those as digits. But the fact that it has parentheses and dashes means you could not enter those as numbers if you want to enter the parentheses and dashes also, or store them that way. And the other issue is you're probably not going to do math, right? We're not going to add up phone numbers or take an average or a sum or anything. So very often I will make phone numbers be a char and then add up all those characters. So if you're going to store it with all of those characters, that would be a char 14. And the same thing with Social Security number. Are we going to take an average of the Social Security numbers or find the max or whatever? So in that case, I would maybe also make that a char because it's not a variable length item, at least phone numbers, Social Security numbers in the United States. So we could just make it a char of however many digits that is. And so in this case, it looks like it's 11, so we'll make that char 11. So those are the data types I would use in this case. So in summary, before we can start creating our tables in MySQL, you need to determine the appropriate data type for each column or field or attribute, whatever we want to call it, of your table. And a lot of times that will involve looking up the actual data types available for the database system you're using. SQL Server is going to be just a little bit different than MySQL, which might be just a little bit different than Oracle.